To set up for the kettlebell sumo deadlift, make sure your feet are wider than your hips and your knees and toes are pointed out with your hips open. Place the kettlebell on the floor in line with the middle of your foot, and as you reach down, keep a nice straight arm, pressing your shoulders down away from your ears. To hinge back, push your bum back away from you with a slight soft knee bend. Your back should be nice and straight here. Make sure as you lift the kettlebell to stand, you're keeping the kettlebell very close to your body. This way, it will take any pressure out of your lower spine. The same process applies for the dual kettlebell sumo deadlift. Simply place the kettlebell side by side. Make sure they are placed in the middle of your foot. Hinge back, so push your bum back away from you. Slight knee bend. And as you lift up, make sure you brace your core, keeping the arms straight and kettlebell stay close to you. The reason for having two kettlebells is to simply add more weight to this movement. If you are fairly tall, like me, you can always place the kettlebell on two plates or some kind of raised platform. What this will do is it will reduce the range of movement. Therefore, if you do slightly feel it in your back, this may help you and prevent you to feel it so much in your back. So try, if you want to raise the kettlebells and to do the sumo deadlift from a raised platform.